Dying friends, this man was so great that even the enemies of Allah and his Rasul acknowledged the greatness of Khalid bin Walid radiallahu ta'ala an. He was a man so great, my young friends, that many from amongst the enemies of Allah and his Rasul actually believed that this man actually carries the sword of Allah, and it is with this sword of Allah this man destroys the enemies of Allah and his Rasul. Battle of Yarmouk, and a senior Roman commander by the name of Jarjar, he wants to meet Khalid bin Walid. He makes his way to Khalid and he says to Khalid, "Oh Khalid, I want you to tell me the truth. Do not lie to me, as a free man does not lie." And he asked, "Oh Khalid, I beg you, tell me the truth. Did Allah send a sword from the heavens and give to your Nabi? And did your Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in turn give you this sword, as a result of which you defeat and destroy your enemy whenever you meet them in battle?" And Khalid bin Walid radiallahu ta'ala replied in the negative. And he told him as to why he was called the sword of Allah. And this had such an impact on the heart of Jarjar, the honesty of Khalid bin Walid, that there and then Jarjar's next question, "Oh Khalid, tell me, what do you invite towards?" And Khalid said, "I invite towards the worship of the one Allah, the Lord of the Arsh and Kursi, my creator, your creator. I invite towards Iman, Islam. I invite towards Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as being the last and final messenger." Jarjar asked, "Oh Khalid, tell me, if somebody were to embrace your religion and declare the kalima la ilaha illallah, what would his maqam and status be in your religion?" Look at the wisdom. Khalid bin Walid responds, "Oh Jarjar, my deen is so beautiful that in my deen everyone is equal. The black, the white, the Arab, the non-Arab, the poor man, the rich man. In my deen, when it comes to the teachings of Allah and his Rasul, and when it comes to showing obedience to Allah and his Rasul, we are all equal. When the poor has to bow down and prostrate before his creator, then the king living in his palace has to bow down and prostrate before his creator. When the poor man has to fast, then the king has to fast."